Jack Daniels and Coke, what a combo. Hey guys, how's it going? James here from Karadu, etc. Today on Judy, I think I've said that's her name before. You know Judy. Today I am installing, or hopefully going to install, some new battery terminals. I've been eager to get into the sound system sort of installations onto this car for a while now, but I mapped out all the steps I need to take to get to the final product, and I want to try and do it as efficiently as I can rather than just buying all the gear and whacking it in. I want to do it in a good step-by-step process. And so the first thing I had to do was upgrade my electrical system, I think. Yeah, from memory. So, because before I could install amplifiers or capacitor or anything like that, I needed to be able to get some zero gauge power wire down there. And to do that, I needed some battery terminals. So today, I'm doing two of these RFDB1 Rockford Fosgate battery terminals. I'll just open this one up real quick here, since I've already had it out and had a look at it. So we got, so this plastic cover comes off, but otherwise this whole thing is pretty much just a solid piece of brass with platinum coating. And it's got two 0-gauge / 4-gauge outputs and two 8-gauge outputs. So obviously you can see those shiny shims in there, they come out. You can have 0-gauge in there, or you can leave it in and have 4-gauge and then two 8-gauges. And I've got two of them, quite clearly one for the positive and one for the negative. So I don't think the negative is going to be too hard. I think I've already had a good look at this. I don't really know what I want to do 100%, but I've got a good idea. And I think what I want to do is have them like this, with the wires coming off backwards rather than going towards the motor. Even though that way you can read it, I think I'd rather have it backwards like this, with the wires sort of laying over top of the battery. Now the positive one is a bit tricky, because there's all of this bullshit, and I'm pretty sure this here is actually an explosive that's designed to explode and break in the event of a very bad short, and that way it completely disrupts the connection between whatever that wire there is connected to and the battery. Yeah, it's just new cars have that sort of thing. So what I'm thinking I want to do is have the terminal like yay on the post, piece of zero gauge comes out, does a nice little loop, and then comes around, and I'm going to put like a big ring spade terminal on it, a really heavy duty one, and then this whole piece here is going to unbolt and bolt onto the big thick piece of zero gauge wire. So this bit and this bit are going to come off, but the wires and the clamps attached to it are going to stay, because I do want this to be factory reversible. I don't want to do what I did in the lignum, which is where I just cut these off completely. I want it to be factory reversible. So depending on how well this goes will determine what I get done today, because it's not a huge time limit, but I am here on a bit of a time limit. It's 5:30 in the evening on a Sunday, so I've actually come in at a time when I'm never at work to do some work on it, and I have to pick up Jess from work at about 11 o'clock-ish. So I've got a good 6 hours I can work with if I want to go straight from here to picking her up. I hope to have some dinner in between somewhere. But if all goes well, maybe I'll get the terminals, maybe the big three upgrade, and maybe even a engine block ground kit done. I kind of want to redo this, like the electrical and this whole bonnet area. Obviously not this bullshit, but I want to do the big three, which I don't know if it is the big three in my case, but I want to upgrade the factory ground cable to a piece of zero gauge. I definitely want to upgrade the alternator cable. Alternator is stock, but from reading the manuals, these things appear to have quite a bit of power output. I actually think I read in one of the manuals for the American version of this car that they have like 110 amp output, which seems absurdly high for a factory alternator. Maybe I'm wrong, you guys tell me. I thought most alternators have like 60 amp output or 50. 110's decent. So I want to upgrade the alternator wire and the ground wire for sure. And I also want to do some more engine grounding. So I want to ground the I want to have a piece of 8 gauge going from the battery to the alternator. There's a nice clamp belt there I can use. Just any sort of places I can find. I can see an empty threaded shaft down there. I could put a big fat bolt in. I could put a piece of 8 gauge to that. That's the engine block there, I'm pretty sure. I'm not a mechanic, so don't ask me, but I'm pretty sure this is the engine block. So I could ground out that piece, the alternator, and just some more over here. Basically, the more spread out you do all of your grounding on the engine, the better, apparently. Now, this is like a bit of a funny thing, because I've seen a lot of sports cars come in, not like sports cars, like sporty cars, like guys who, you know, want to make their cars a bit faster, and they've put these engine grounding kits in, and I'm told it reduces, it increases your horsepower output by like at the most 10 horsepower, which is obviously nothing and like negligible. But to be honest, I think they look quite cool once they're in here, like, you know, nice bits of 8-gauge wire going everywhere. It looks quite nice if you've got good wire. So I think I'd like to do that as well. I mean, why not? I've got the cable for it. So that's what I want to do under the bonnet. So yeah, piece of zero gauge coming out of there to that. There will definitely be a piece of zero gauge coming out of this, going to a big fuse holder, and then going through that grommet there all the way to the back where the amps and capacitor are going to be. Not doing that part today because I didn't bring my fuse holder in with me, but I think I want to mount my fuse holder in here because I've got one of those big long ugly A&L fuse holders, and then so that can go there, and then the zero gauge can continue from there through that grommet and down to the boot. Because you guys are going to laugh at me because zero gauge is just way overkill for what I'm putting in this car, because I'm not putting in anything less powerful than what I had in the Legnum. It's just the funny fact that the amps I'm putting in don't even take 8-gauge power wire. I'm putting in, you know, those Rockford Fosgate micro amplifiers that take at most 10-gauge power wire, so zero gauge for the main supply just seems ridiculous, but why not? Overkill is better than underkill in my opinion. This, by the way, is the power wire I want to use. If I could, I would use blue for power and silver for ground, but unfortunately I have the wrong amounts for that. I have enough silver for the power cable and enough blue for the ground cable. So that's what I'm going to, the way I'm going to be doing it. Blue is going to be ground, silver is going to be power. That's just the way it is. Oh, and the reason I'm using this and not the stuff I had in my Legnum, because I did take all that out, is because this is Rockford Fosgate power wire and I just want it to be brand matched just for the sake of it. This is a bit of a weird video. It's like a really tedious, stupid little job and I'm doing a lot of iffy, finicky things about it, but hopefully you guys enjoy it. Hopefully I succeed. Yeah. But first, one thing I do think I need to do is export my sound settings from this onto a storage device of some kind, because every time I disconnect the battery, the sound settings are lost. And I think I can export them somehow. I've seen it somewhere. Oh, it's that thing there. Oh, okay, so it's just the visual settings. Oh, well, in that case, I might as well do it. Illumination, theme and splash screen, exporting. Okay, well, that's done. So the sound settings are gonna be lost regardless. Oh well. Now I need to disconnect the battery, which should just be a couple of 10mm bolts. As you can tell, I'm in full casual wear today. Jandals and all. It's hot here. What temperature is it? 27 degrees outside. Right, let's disconnect these wires. There's the negative. Gone. We have lost power. If I can this off. I'm holding a camera and this thing at the same time. It's not helping. Ah! There we go. There's the negative loose. There are two wires going to this negative terminal. One of them definitely just goes to there. Not sure where the other one goes. Put that down there. And now the positive. Positive is at 12. I should, I think, try and chop this video up into some sections. Oh god, that's tight. So that it doesn't get too boring too quickly. Because you guys don't need to. There we go. I just had to break that first before I undid the terminal, otherwise it would have been impossible. Undo this nut. Lift that off. That's, oh wait, there's more. Okay, so there's these ones and that one on the positive terminal, just like that. Okay, now I can loosen that off some more. There we go, there's the positive terminal. Probably be a lot easier if I just put the camera down here. So there, hopefully this just sits straight on. Okay, so it doesn't. So I think we take this shim out of this one. I'm pretty sure this just fits straight over the negative though. Yes, it does. That fits straight over the negative, but not quite straight over the positive. I think we need to take that metal shim out of there. Okay, there we go. Got the shim out. Now hopefully this just sits over here. It does, just like that. Sweet. It's a wee bit tight, but I think if we just work it down a wee bit, because it doesn't go all the way for some reason. But if we, oh, that must be as low as it goes, I think. Okay. Oh, I see. Yeah, this post gets wider as it goes down. So what I might have to do is shave some of the bottom of the lead off this post so that this can go all the way down. That's how it goes all the way down to there. So at least, oh, okay, it's definitely going to be up a wee bit. How do I know if it's all the way down? Oh, maybe it won't go all the way down because it has to allow for that plastic cap to go on it. That would make sense, wouldn't it? I can see. Oh, man, it almost goes all the way down. But I think that there is it. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, okay. So that's cool. So what I can do now is I've got that in kind of the position I want. facing straight backwards. Just get that nicely tightened up. Okay, that's that. Now this should just pop on. Yes, it does. Cool. That's good. It gets back off like that. Cool, that's one. And this one, the shim stays in it, and we should just be able to plonk that on there. Nice. And then tighten it up here. If you're wondering about whether or not I'm thinking of upgrading the battery, at this stage, no, just because this battery is like as new as the car, so it's only 2 years old, and it's got decent power. Well, I don't know how good it is, but it'll have probably quite decent output. And also because of the other couple of reasons, A being that I don't really sit in my car and listen to music with the car off for long stretches of time, and B, the amplifiers I'm installing have very little current draw. So I don't think I'm going to need to upgrade my battery or my alternator. The fact that I have zero gauge wire is just me being ridiculous and overkill. So that's why I'm probably going to leave it factory. For my ground upgrade, I'm definitely going to leave that factory ground on, but I'm also going to put a new big fat ground on, probably going down to a bolt that is down here, I think. There's a bolt going into the chassis there. I just need to undo that. It's an M6. M6 isn't very big for a zero gauge wire, but it's not the bolt that does it. It just, you know what I mean. What I think I need to do first out of anything though is try and get this positive wire situation sorted out so that it's not going to be an issue, because I want these basically to sit with each other. Basically what I want them to do is sit sort of there in that position there, and then a nice piece of wire can come around and go in. I'd be happy with that. I just don't know how I'm going to stop it from trying to move around. Hopefully this red thing will still go on it afterwards. That would be good. That would probably stop it from going anywhere if that was in that position there. So what I'm going to do is get some of my silver power cable and figure out what side I want to go in. I think I'll use the closest one to go to this, and the far away one to go further around, further down, duck down, come up. So maybe what I should do is use a piece of wire first to figure out what length I need, and then chop the thick stuff. That would make sense. I'll use a piece of 8 gauge. Here we go, I even got a silver bit. So this silver 4 gauge is going to be my theoretical zero gauge, so I'm just going to use this to measure what length I think I need. And I quite like the idea of the wires just popping out straight backwards, but rather than curving around straight away. So what I want it to do is come out of there, because that's about how far in I think it's going to go, like that. Then it's going to go straight down. So I decided to take the terminal back off and put the wire into it first, rather than try and do it with it in the car, because I thought that was going to be much harder. So I'm doing it this way. Took a few goes, because as soon as you take the insulation off this big 1 gauge wiring, the wire just like expands everywhere, and it's really hard to get it in the actual hole of this thing. Tighten that up. Good. Okay, there we go. Go put this back on. Actually, I might use the nut and bolt and do that part first. Let's have a go at it. Bolt through that one. Oh, come on, come on, come on. There we go. Do as you're told. That one. And that on the bottom. Okay, yeah, I'm definitely going to need to get myself a socket. It's a 13 mil. Okay. Got my little quarter inch breaker bar. Can go under there. And then this ratchet spanner. Away. There we go. I'd say that is on pretty well. Now I wonder, if I put this on, will it stay there? It might do. There we go, that's clipped. So now that can stay there. And this reaches up to here and slots on. Is there anything else I need to do? No, I'm just doing this for now, aren't I? Yeah. That's tight, and this one I'm pretty sure is quite tight as well. There we go, now that's definitely tight. Sweet, factory positive reconnected. And it's all protected by that shield as well. Might have to do something to stop that from rattling, but I'm not sure yet, we'll see how we go. Maybe I could put some double-sided tape along there and then stick it to the side of the battery or something. Now this ground. Okay, so I'm going to have to put an extension on this as well so they can come around and into there, which I would do, I think, just with a piece of 4 gauge. Oh. So I think I'll extend this piece out just with a piece of 4 gauge around to there, since I am going to be doing my own big 0 gauge ground anyway. I don't really need to make that a 0 gauge. Oops, so I can take this off the rest of the way, I think. Oh crap, is this all one big, oh my god, it is. Now that's annoying, guys. I thought that was going to unbolt, but that's actually just a tightening thing. Oh bugger. So okay, what I shall do instead then. Bugger, I thought that was going to unbolt from itself. It looks like it does. Well then really what I need to do is undo some of that tape and have a look at what's in behind it. Wonder if I could uncrimp that. I doubt it, but it'd be cool if I could. Oh yeah, I do doubt I'm going to get that undone. I think I may have to cut it, guys. That's annoying. On the plus side though, both of these two could go into the 8 gauge terminals of that. Or I could just put a lug underneath there, wrap this all up in tape and leave the terminal on there. It might be a better way to go. What I'm going to do first, rather than worrying about this factory negative wire, is I'm going to upgrade my big ground wire with this 0 gauge from the terminal down to that bolt down there under that bracket, because that's right on the chassis rail. So I need to undo that, try and move that bracket out of the way and scratch off the paint, and then I'm going to make up my big ground wire out of that, and I'm hoping I'll have enough excess left over from that to have another run coming out of there to do something else, because I quite like the idea of having two big silver ones come out and two big blue ones come out. I thought it would look quite cool, so I'm gonna do that first. It ain't moving, bugger. I don't think I can use that point, guys, that because that bracket won't move out of the way and it has to go right onto the metal. That's annoying. I'm pretty sure there isn't anything to see underneath because there's all that frickin' paneling down there. Oh, why is it? This car is becoming particularly hard to work on, I have to say. Okay, possibly. I'm thinking what I might do now, guys, is put the ground, obviously another one of these big lugs, and I think I might be able to do it just here. There's a big flat spot of metal I think I could use. I would have to draw my own hole though and use my own bolt fastener to hold it down, rather than my own like PK fastener self-tapping, rather than a bolt to hold it down though, which is its downside. But I think it could be okay. Now that I've got that out of the way, I can at least, you know, get to it and drill the hole out. Because what needs to happen is it needs to be as far, where is my finger? I can't even see it. As far this way as possible, because the wire is going to have to come out and make a straight U-turn straight up. So I think that could be a good option down there. Because obviously all the way along here there's fuel lines or brake lines or whatever the fuck this shit is. And again, what I think I'm going to do is get this right angle drill bit and drill through that lip you can see up there, through all four layers of steel, brush off one of the sides with the wire brush, and then mount the lug to there and have it bent on a 90 degree, same as what I had with the positive one. What did I do with the lug? Probably lost it. Where is it? Now I can't find the frickin' lug. Where is it? Oh my god. Things definitely aren't going as smoothly as I'd hoped. But that's cars. This is going to be a really slow, annoying drill. Fucking slipping. Should be a 6mm hole all the way through. You get a 6mm bolt. Does it? It does fit. Sweet. Okay, good news, that worked. So now I need to, I think the best thing to do now would be to put the lug on the end of the blue wire, bend it, and then I could just file this now, I suppose. Let's file this now. Okay, so I've got my big long power wire with the crimp on the end. Don't need to hand shrink this one because it's negative. I've got my nut and my bolt. Now I need to try and get it all in there and then put the battery back in. Okay. I did brush off the paint off the other side there. So that's all good and ready for contact, just like that. Or maybe I could even have it down on a right angle like that. That could be cool. That would make it easier to tighten up and everything. I much prefer using bolts or nut and bolts if I can for grounds, because you can tighten them up really tight, but with self-tapping screws you can over-tighten them and you can thread, or you can just like rip the self-tapping screw straight through its hole. There we go, that is well on there. That looks like a good ground to me. So now I can put the tray back in and the battery. I'm happy with that. That's good. I'm happy with that. So now this thing literally was just sitting here, kind of like that. Oh, I see, that slots into there. That slots into there, that's how it sits, okay. Now I have to do the tricky thing of trying to get this wire into here. And what side do I want to use? That's the other question. Now, can this go through here? The question. Oh damn, that's a tough thing to cut. Gotcha. Now I need to take some off. Not too much, because last time I took off too much. It goes in there. Let me tighten this up. Now I still need to work out something for this factory negative. I'm just trying to decide whether I want to use a piece of eight gauge going to it, or if I want to use a piece of zero gauge going to it, and then the two pieces of eight gauge can go to the engine block and the alternator bracket. I think I should just use the zero gauge piece for it, which is stupid. Although I could use the zero gauge to go to that engine block piece. Although I do want something for down that end. I think because I want to save some of this for the back end of the car where I'm grounding out my capacitor, I'm going to use this to go to the factory grounds, that short little jump there, and then I'm going to use 8 gauges to go to the engine block and the alternator bracket, but I'll use good quality Monster stuff, so that'll be okay. So now I need to figure out how to get a piece of this zero gauge to connect to this. Okay guys, what I ended up doing while the GoPro was charging because it ran out of battery is I ended up chopping the connection off the factory ground stuff and putting its own lug on there, and then obviously I've got the zero gauge with a big lug on there and just a nice M6 bolt holding those two together, and I can't even pivot those now, so that's nice and tight. And then I've got a big piece of heat shrink which I'm about to put over it, which is, and then this is going to go up to the terminal. So that's what I'm up to now. It's getting dark in here. What time is it? It's like 7:45. That's a long job just for a pretty simple terminal replacement, isn't it? Shrink this. There we go, shrunk. So now this can be nicely down there, out of the way. Jess is texting me, asking me how I'm going. Now this is gonna be down. Come on, down you go. Girl, what you playing at? Girl, come on, Judy. And I'm going behind this bolt here. It's just getting in the way. So this needs to reach up into there. So now I can chop this one. I'm just gonna get that cover and put that over there because I don't want to touch that yet. Oh, stay there please. So I should chop this about there, I suppose. Choppers. Okay, now I have to just squeeze. Gotcha. Not too much. There we go. Oh, swarf everywhere. I hate doing that around the cars because all the little fibers that you cut as you're doing the shrink removing, not the shrink, the shield removing, just go everywhere. Okay, now if I could just get this to go into here, that would be much appreciated. Thank you, God. Okay, it's in. Why do I always lose the Allen key right when I need it? How do I do it, guys? How? Where have I put it? Where's... I had it just here. And I think once I've done this, I'll be pretty much done for the terminal replacement, and part of the big three upgrade is done. I don't know, is it a big three for me? Because I'm doing alternator wire, ground wire, what's the other one you're supposed to do? Engine block wire, I guess? So yeah, we'll be doing a big three. That's pretty tight. I can tighten those up once they're on the terminal post. Now, doing this will actually put power back on the car. Do I want to do that yet, or do I want to do the... Do I want to keep working? Or should I? Well, I don't know. What should I do? I might just put it on temporarily. Come on, down you go. Okay, these are a wee bit firmer than I'd like them to be. Is that going to fit through that gap? Okay, guys. So, I got the... Obviously, the power for that stuff done. I got both of these terminals on. It's all good. I think I am going to try and hustle tonight and get an alternator wire, an alternator bracket wire, and maybe an engine block wire done. So that'll be the big three and new terminals done tonight. That would be quite cool to get that all done. I just switched over to a new memory card because I filled that last one up. And I just realized when I turned it on that for some reason it was in 1080p linear, so it was just a real direct field of view, not fisheye. So I'm really sorry if any of the shots up until now have been kind of just looking or almost half looking at the thing and you guys can't really see. So I'm sorry if any of those shots are messed up, but I usually leave my GoPro on super view, but for some reason today it wasn't. I must have been shooting something at the office. So sorry about that. Moving on, for the alternator wires, which are what I'm going to do first, I'm going to use some nice good quality 8 gauge wire that I've got here. Monster. I haven't got any Rockford Fosgate 8 gauge or any blue or good quality silver, so I'm just going to use this black and red stuff because I know it's really good quality. So obviously red for the alternator, black for the engine block and for the alternator bracket. And I don't know if you guys can see this, but if I bring it up real close you might be able to. You can see that the shielding or the insulation on this is actually really thin, and it's almost like 80%, I'd say, copper. So this is really good quality 8 gauge. It's doesn't say how many strands it is. No, it doesn't say. All I know is that Monster cable is really, really good. So I probably, I think, want to run it down around behind the battery and up along the factory loom to the alternator. So what I might do is get a piece of just basic wire, sort of lay it along so I can gauge how long I think it needs to be, and then I can copy that length to there rather than working with the big heavy stuff because that's just annoying to hold it in place. So just this piece of wire here. See, this is good because it's actually kind of almost the thickness of 8 gauge, but it's not all raw copper like that. Okay. And for the negative side, I'm not actually going to use that bolt here that I saw earlier down there. There's a threaded point just there under the shroud that I can get to, which isn't being used. So that'll be a good point to get my alternator negative at. I know that I maybe probably don't even need to be doing this, but I just like working on the car, and if there's something that can be upgraded that I can do to maybe help the system, then I want to, just because, you know, I enjoy it. Why not? This is like, I probably don't even, you know what I'm saying, right? Like, I don't need to be doing all these upgrades for the size of the system I'm putting in this car, but it's fun to. And it means if I want to put a big system in later on, I can, because I've already run zero gauge down the back, so I could put big amps in if I wanted more power. So this needs to run from, oh, and I've got the negative off, so this isn't live anymore, so that's all good. So I can run that along there. Yeah, now do I want to just, I think I'll just jump that gap. If I can pull this through with a bit of excess. Cool. So now I know how long my piece of 8 gauge, at least from a negative side, needs to be. Obviously the positive will be just a wee bit shorter. Now I can cut this. And now I'm just waiting. Hold on. This red's all gunky. I want some nice fresh stuff. There we go. I don't know what was up with that other roll of red. We've got two rolls of this stuff, and for some reason that roll I had out here was like all gunky and covered in dust and something. I'm not sure. Now, should I cut the other negative now? Maybe I should measure that out as well. Okay. Now I've got my two negatives and my positive. And that's good because it actually leaves a terminal in this positive block free in case there's anything I need to wire up here with a really good power supply in the future. Which reminds me, I've actually got some air horns that I got from a garage sale which work, which I might put in here. And they're frickin' loud. Don't know where I'd put them. There's no room down in here. This engine bay is full up. Might have to go to the back there somewhere. But anyway, another day. I could probably wire up my two negative sides. to the terminal. Doesn't really matter which is top and bottom. There we go. See what I mean? How much copper there is compared to insulation. So it's very good quality 8 gauge. Okay. Those are in there. Now I can thread them down along the line. And I think while I'm here, I'll put the positive one in as well. In you slot. Ow! Did you guys see that? Fucking magnets. I thought it was the bonnet coming down, scared the shit out of me. Okay guys, so I've kind of motored ahead, got it all done. I was thinking there's probably not much point in me showing you too much detail because the lighting in here is actually really poor, even with that little LED lamp I had hooked up. So hopefully what you were seeing looked good, but here's what it looks like now. The only thing I haven't done is put this cover back on because I wanted to show you. This normally sits here, but there's the negative going to the bracket of the alternator. Nice crimp on there with a big nut with a big bolt going through that threaded point. Here's our red wire going in underneath the factory OEM power wire, and then it all just runs back along here and around. And also, if you can see down in there, is the engine block ground that I talked about. See that there? And that just joins up with the rest of it. I put some cable ties on it to keep it all in check. Ducks down with the rest of them and they all pop up and go to the terminals. I kind of like it when it sits like that, nice and straight, but I feel like it's not going to stay that way on its own, so I'm not sure if I'll do anything about that or not. But I do like the way it looks with like two fat ones and two thin ones, and then this one isn't going to have another thin one, but there will be a fat piece of silver coming out of here going up to a fuse holder and through to the back. So I'm really happy with how it's looking. I thought about whether or not I wanted to put these bits in conduit or not, but I've run them in a way that I think they're going to be protected pretty well from heat. And I don't know, because like all this conduit you see here is wrapped in electrical tape, and electrical tape does melt when near heat, and since none of it has even shown any signs of melting, I think it's pretty well away from the heat. There's a heat guard here, and I intentionally ran it on this side of the master loom so that it couldn't get too hot, so I think we're going to be all good. The only one I would nearly really need to worry about getting hot would be the power one anyway, because even if the insulation melted entirely off these negative ones, off the black ones, it wouldn't be a problem because all of the engine is negatively charged anyway, so that won't be a problem. But yeah, I'm real happy with how it looks. I'll quickly with my hands put that back on there. Like that. Get a screwdriver to help. And with that, we were done. So I haven't really done a full engine bay grounding kit as much as I was thinking I would originally, like I've seen in some cars, but I have put a better, well, a nice, short, good quality ground from the battery straight to a big point on the engine block, so I'm happy with that. And I've got an even stronger ground going, well, another strong ground going to the alternator and a second power wire for the alternator, so I'm happy about that. Only thing I think I'm gonna do now, if I can get this off, oh, I can, look at that. Let's have a look here. This is the factory grounding point where the battery grounds to the chassis. And see how good a quality this is. Have they taken the paint off, is what I'm wondering. The answer is no, they have not. So that's something I can do. I'm going to take all the paint off that section there and reground that properly, because it's shocking when companies do that. Let's try and do this without making a mess. I might stand you guys up on your feet so I can use two hands for control. There we go. Got rid of all the paint off there. And now we can reground that properly. Even just doing this to your car can make a huge difference to your electrical system, because manufacturers don't care that much. They do what's necessary to get the car going and operating, but they don't try to make things like as optimal or as good as they could be. So now that terminal for the ground is sitting on raw metal, which is what you want, because paint isn't a conductor, which means it was using the bolt as a conductor. But you're better off having surface area contact than like that to that and there again. Hopefully that makes sense, but just trust me, you're better off having that paint missing. I'm sure a lot of you already know that. But that pretty much wraps up the car for tonight, guys. I'm gonna put my tools all back. What time is it? It's 9:12. When did I start? Like 5:45, I think I said I started. So 4.5 hours just for some new battery terminals. Sound man speed.
Got it!
I'll probably break this down into about 50 episodes spanning a couple years. Call it a component of a job partially done. Ain't that right, Felipe?
Ooh, yeah.
I've still got a good piece of blue 1-gauge that I can use for my ground in the boot, which I'm happy about. That way, the wiring up here is going to match the wiring down there. And I'm probably going to wire up the amps the same way as well, because my 0-gauge is going to be silver for positive and blue for negative, and then the power supply at the amplifiers is going to be red and black, same as what I've got for these 8-gauge pieces up here. So it's all going to look good. Yeah, cool. Now before I tell you that I'm done, let's try and start the car, shall we? Hopefully everything is all good. No tools left anywhere. Oh, there's one. Black handles disguising themselves. Everything looks good. Let's try and start the car. I wonder how possible it is that the battery might be flat. Everything in here is working, which means I haven't got any polarities on the wrong way. I think we'd know if I'd done that. Yep, we're back to Japanese. Let's start the car. Any alerts? Seem to be good. I wonder if I can change this language back. No, I have to have the doors closed and stuff. It's okay, I know how to change the language back to English. I actually made a video a while ago about how to do that. Click the card up here for that, if you have one of these cars. So we're all good, yay. Oh, stereo is back to factory settings, of course. I'll have to set that all up. But yeah, it is, as I say, 9:15. Turn that off so you can hear me. So as I say, it's 9:15. I'm feeling very stiff and knackered. It's the end of the weekend and I get to get up and go to work tomorrow, so yay for me. Thanks for watching this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I don't expect you to have enjoyed this video outright on its own, because let's face it, all I did was put on some new terminals, though they are quite nice and I like them. I hope some of you are getting excited to see the system go into duty. That's the whole reason I want to document every single aspect of this. That's why I made videos about, what was the most basic video I did on this? I almost made a video about me replacing the interior dome lights, but I think I scrapped that because it was too simple. Oh, probably the most basic video I've made was replacing the park lights and tail lights, the park lights and the number plate lights with blue LEDs. And that's why so as you can see, I'm documenting the whole process of this car because it's fun, and I want you guys to see the progress I make on it and see how I do everything intricately, rather than just being someone who pops up on YouTube and says, this is my car and it has all this stuff in it and that's about it. I want you guys to see the process, and hopefully you'll learn something from it as well. I'm really happy with that. That little section right there all of a sudden looks so much more grunty. It's gonna look good with another piece of silver going there. Right, I'm rambling. Time to go, guys. Thank you so much for watching this video. Hope you've enjoyed it. Hope you're enjoying the Project Legacy series. Choose to be happy, and I'll catch you in my next video. Ka kite anō.